Mr. Bob's Burgers Rick and Morty obsession, and the British YouTuber. You must be Lamborghini Strikes Back one, alright? Yeah. First off, my name is Wolf. No, it's Death. Nice to meet you. I'm a huge fan of your videos. I'm gonna be really nice. Of all, and maybe the villain in the movie, but I'm gonna be very nice to you. I'm not gonna hunt you down. I'm actually not after you. And I heard you also like Loud House and Casa Grande's, and you do ship Luna Lau and Sam Sharp, isn't that right? The LGBT couple themselves. Yeah, that's me. I'm not after you, Lamb. I'm not after you, Lamps. I'm after this YouTuber. That's right. I'm after this Trolls Freak Jerk Lord, known as Trolls Band Together Fan 2001. As his old name in Psyop Fan 2001. A YouTuber you used to like back then, but unfortunately his views went to an utter downfall. He clapped for James Bond's death, and he praised Trolls Band Together like it's better than freaking God. He's basically the childish dad of YouTube, and he's pretty much Princess Mortbox from the Powerpuff Girls, and he praised Trolls too much. So, I'll tell you what, after I hunt him down, I'll give you the £9,000 reward for you, for being a great YouTuber. You've worked so hard on Tim Hortons, and you need the money, and I do. Thanks, Wolf, nice to, let's shake hands. Okay, I'm after Trolls Band Together Fan 2001. Meanwhile, at Trolls Band Together Fan 2001's house, and previously from his Troll Band Together rant, that Lambo did a couple of weeks ago.
Oh my god, Bobby, my Trolls merch has been taken away because Lambo and his gang hates me with a burning passion now because he's been teasing me because I praise Trolls too much. He hates my family of all time. Excuse me. I'm gonna answer the door, Poppy and Viva. Yeah. Yes?
Guys, this is for comedy purpose only, guys, just to let you know.
No, my house is...
Now before I start this with you, now my original opening, I was originally going to do an opening scene of me entering the pub, and then Lou Loud and Dr. Zoidberg. I'll do my character presentation of these two characters serving me as a free drink, as since I'm a fan of those shows, and then the wolf will come in, and the wolf will be in my intro of that scene of the serve me. That was the original pitch for my opening for this review, but unfortunately due to the fact my dad is at home and my mom's at work, and I can't make videos at home because you guys probably know what I mean, and because I'm trying to keep my childhood secret for my family. My plan for that opening pretty much got scrapped. So I decided to do a different alternative opening to the opening I got now. So, but hey guys, it doesn't matter guys. At least I get to do the review on this movie, so that's something to say. So that's my original opening I was originally going to do, but it's okay guys. at least you hope you guys enjoyed the intro. This is that intro. It's not an extreme. It's for comedy purpose only. You guys probably know how much I despise Charles Band Scare Band 2001, aka Charles Free Dirt Lord, and he's now officially the worst YouTuber I've ever seen in my life. Yep. Even worse than Luigi Marvis Gaming. I can't believe I said it. I mean, but I'm not gonna say much. But guys, let's just get started with this. So anyway, hey guys, it's Lamborghini Strikes Back once again. I know, I am nearly 2 years late on this with you. I know you're thinking, Lambo, why are you 2 years late on this movie? It's the fact that one certain YouTuber keep begging me to do a review on this movie known as Luigi Mavis Gaming. And I was nearly put my foot down to not do a review at all, but thankfully, thank God, he didn't beg me to do a review recently, which good riddance. Thank God I blocked him. He's a terrible YouTuber, but I'm just saying, guys. But thankfully, that's in the past, and now I can review on this movie. So, Puss in Boots: The Last Wish came out in 2023 in my country, and came out in 2022 in the USA, Canada, etc. So it came out the exact same year as The Batman, Sonic the Hedgehog 2, The Bad Guys, Bob's Burgers movie, Lightyear, Mean Rise of Gru, Thor: Love and Thunder, Black Panther: Wakanda Forever, etc. So basically I mentioned all the movies that I went to see in 2022 in that year. So, and of course it came out the same year as the piece of shit known as Marvel 2022. And oh god no, it came out the same year as fucking motherfucking Mobius! Three words, fuck that movie in the arse. That is the second worst movie I've ever seen in my life. Fuck you, Mobius, you piece of shit. Guys, just kidding, guys. Just a joke, guys. It's Mervin time. Quiet, Mobius. I hate that film, The Burning Passion. That is the second worst movie I've ever seen in my life. Enough talking. It's just a joke, guys. Let's get into the topic. The review on this movie. Let's dive into the plot. So, basically, the plot is it takes place right after the first movie left off. After Puss in Boots gave all the eggs to the goose from the end of the first movie, which I actually did rewatch that film on film 4 back in during December during my Christmas break, and it all went so everyone's happy. They say, who's your favorite hero? That who's your famous hero? That intro, and then suddenly a wolf has come, and he's still wanted, and of course Puss in Boots has been wasting his 8 lives. He's got only one more life to live, and of course he's a cat. Of course, cats run 9 lives. So, and then of course he's got this last wish. He's up with this Petro, the and Kitty Softpaw from the first movie. She came back in the sequel, and of course they're up there to get the last wish. And of course Gordiox and Jack and even Death the Wolf are after it, up to Puss in Boots, and that second samurai's what the plot is. Now, DreamWorks is nowadays, they are starting to run out of ideas. They actually kind of starting to run out of ideas in 2020 decade, because I just think DreamWorks are kind of went flush down the drain now, because now, if you guys wondering, do I hate DreamWorks? No, I do not hate DreamWorks. DreamWorks is actually part of my childhood, but I do prefer the DreamWorks from the 2000 decade, 2010 decade, and the 2020 decade has been kind of hit and miss. So, and before I get into my thoughts on the DreamWorks movie in this decade, now let me talk about the opening logo, the newest opening logo. So, and I'm not going to show you the logo because I don't want to show the video, I don't want to get copyright. The new opening logo, it has the bad guys, Toothless, it has bad guys, he has Toothless from How to Train Your Dragon, and he has Poppy from Trolls, and he has Kung Fu Panda, Poe from Kung Fu Panda, and even the piece of shit boss, even the shit baby is in that logo. Oh, that's the nickname, the shit baby. No, it's the boss baby. And then he has Fiona, Donkey, and Shrek, and as the DreamWorks move into the newest logo, and I gotta say, it was a very lovely, it was a wonderful logo. And then later, around I think it's Chores Band Together, they updated and add Eve from The Croods, which I'm a huge fan of The Croods movies. I love The Croods movies. They are absolutely very fun movies. They're not masterpieces, but they're absolutely hilarious movies that me and my mom love watching The Croods quite a lot. Along with my dad. My dad and I and my mom love The Croods. And we went to see the sequel in 2021. And it has Alex and Marty from Madagascar. Who doesn't love Madagascar? Madagascar is an absolute classic. It's a great franchise. And definitely a great franchise growing up. I used to love watching growing up. And the new logo was absolutely amazing. Now it comes to the 2020 decade for DreamWorks. It's been a rocky journey. So let's do a recap, because I've seen all of them except for Coffee Panda 4, which I have not seen. I might go see it, I might not, because it got mixed reviews. It kind of really scares me, because Mike Mitchell directing that movie, that really kind of bugs me. And I do think a fourth Coffee Panda film is a bit unnecessary. I think the third film is great as it is. Enough talking, let's get into the recaps. Now, Trolls World Tour, I don't really talk about that movie on my channel often due to that one toxic YouTuber praised the new film Black is Better Than Freaking God. I still enjoyed the film, but however, guys, I haven't seen Trolls World Tour for 3 years. The last time I watched that film was back in May 2021 on Sky Cinema. And it was one of the few last movies I watched on Sky Cinema before I watched at my old home before me and my family moved to a new house. And then they made The Croods: A New Age, which I really enjoy, and I'm in the minority. I actually like that film more than the first movie, and unfortunately it was the final DreamWorks movie I actually enjoyed. And unfortunately they made Boss Baby: Family Business, and even the Peter Schindler is Spirit Untamed. This is when I started to lose my faith on DreamWorks. This is when I started to just lose my faith on DreamWorks. I was like, that's it, DreamWorks. I'm done with DreamWorks. I'm not gonna watch any new films. And then they made Bad Guys, which I was sort of trying. I was like, oh, okay, I'm done with DreamWorks. I'm not gonna watch Bad Guys. I'm just gonna skip it and wait till it's on Sky Cinema. I'm done with DreamWorks. And until my family offered me, you want to go see it as my birthday present. I saw my actual birthday, and honestly, it surprised the hell out of me. I love The Bad Guys. That film is a freaking masterpiece. It's a masterpiece. Then they made this movie as a masterpiece, which we'll get to the rest of my thoughts in the movie very soon. And then they made Ruby Gilman Teenage Kraken, which I know the film got mixed reviews. Unfortunately, the movie bombed at the box office. But I just think Ruby Gilman Teenage Kraken, it needs a bit more tension. It needs a bit more attention. It's not a perfect film. It's a fun film overall. It's a fun movie overall. But I do think Ruby Gillen does need a bit more attention, because I think Ruby Gillen's a cute character. I think she's actually my favorite character of the movie. Except they gave away spoilers of Chelsea as the villain, which I don't hate Chelsea, but they just gave away spoilers in the movie. And then they made the Megamind sequel on Peacock, which I have not seen yet. And then they made the last year's Trolls Band Together. Funny enough, I was originally going to see that movie in cinemas, but due to that, some two YouTubers overhyped that movie non-stop. It just made me don't want to go see the movie in cinemas. I just put my foot down, like, you know, fuck it, I'm going to see the Marvels instead. And I did watch it, and oh god, it was fucking terrible. It was fucking terrible. I didn't like Trolls Band Together. That is coming to me who enjoyed the first two films, but this is how they repay me. I don't feel betrayed. It just wasn't a good film. And honestly, guys, I just think the Trolls movies, it needs to rest. And now they make Coming Back to 4, which I have not seen. Like I said, I might see it, I might not. It depends on my work schedule. And we'll see how it goes, guys. I'm not in a rush to see Coming Back to 4 in cinema. That's why I love the first three films. I'm not really in a rush to see it, but despite I'm looking forward to it, but I'm not in a rush to see it, but we'll see how it goes, guys. But we'll definitely watch it at some point. So, and then they made, and then now we're getting The Wild Robot next year. I mean, The Wild Robot this year, and Bad Guys 2 the next year, which I'm really hyped for. So, as for this movie, I watched it twice.
So I've watched the movie twice in Sky Cinema. I haven't watched it on DVD yet, but I watched the movie twice on right now. So one thing of Christmas Last Wish, this is a great film. This is a masterpiece and definitely a huge improvement to the first movie. So, and this is from the director of The Croods New Age, which I enjoyed. So now let's get into the story. Now the story of this movie is actually a little bit better than the story in the first movie. The story was basically a simple story of Puss in Boots and going on an adventure with Kitty Sopor and Humpty Alex on the Dumpty. And if you guys have seen the first movie, you already know Humpty Alex on the Dumpty is not in the sequel because he died. He died in the first movie because he fell off that cliff at the end, and then he turned to the golden egg. And fun fact, he's voiced by Felix Fishoda from Bob's Burgers. Yep, that's right. Felix Fishoda from Bob's Burgers. He's the voice of Humpty Alex on the Dumpty and Joker from the Lego Batman movie. Which I do like Felix Fishoda in Bob's Burgers, but I fucking hate his cousin, Grover Fishoda, from the movie. Fuck that character in the ass. Now the story is actually very great. Now let's get into the animation. The animation is basically like Spider-Verse vibes. It's like the animation looks like Spider-Verse, but it's actually a great animation. Now, funny enough, Charles Band Together Fan 2001, he hates the Spider-Verse films, but he loves this movie and Teenage Mutant Turtles Mutant Mayhem. Now, I have not seen Mutant Mayhem yet, guys, because it just came to Sky Cinema recently, but I have not seen that movie yet. Guys, just to let you guys know. So, and of course, one person at work spoiled the movie for me, which I don't want to get started on that, so. So, let's get into the characters. Puss in Boots is an absolute great character. Voiced by the same person who played all the Shrek films. He was great. Kitty Sopor is a great character. She has more to do in this movie compared to she did in the first movie. In a video, even Petrol, the one that they team up in the movie, he's actually great and he's actually hilarious. And of course, this movie had three villains in one movie. That's right, this movie did the Shipman 3 style with having three villains in one movie. Yeah, aka Spider-Man 3, I call it Shipman 3, that's the title deserves to be called. And yes, this movie has three villains in one movie, but at least this movie, it worked. It worked having three villains in it. I mean, we have Jack, played by Spider-Ham himself. He was great in this movie. He's absolutely hilarious, and he has some good lines in the movie. Wait, and then we have Gordiox. Then we have Gordiox himself. That's right. Gordiox and the Three Bears is also the main another villain of the movie, and she's also Frozen 2004's favorite character in the movie. She was surprisingly great in the movie. She's actually a really good character in this movie. It's kind of interesting she teamed up with the Three Bears, and it was absolutely great and really interesting at the same time. And of course, my favorite character in the movie is the wolf. Death the wolf is my favorite character of the movie. Well. Well done, Lambs. You put me as your favorite character of the entire movie. Bravo, Lambs. Bravo. You can take the £9,000 because I defeat Charles Band Together in 2001. Here you go. Thank you. I have some favorite scene in the movie. My favorite scene in the movie is the open scene, who's your favorite hero, and of course the climax in the movie. The climax of the movie is absolutely great. It's absolutely epic. So overall, I have another great scene in this movie. It's a scene where Puss in Boots have grown a beard, he has a moustache and stuff, and then Kitty Sopor has shaved his beard off and all that stuff. It's just like old times, it's just like the time when you saved me, just like from the last movie. It was actually great. So overall, I had nothing else to say. There's actually a lot of people who love this movie, like Jeremy loves this movie, Jose Critic loves this movie, On Jojo 100 loves this movie, so is Michael's fanboy, Grant the Cat loves this movie, I do as well. I'm not mentioning Charles Peak Jerk Lord and even the other YouTuber I hate who like this movie because I don't give a two fucks about them. So that's what I want to say. Frozen 2004 also love this movie, and so does Nick is 2001, also love this movie as well. So overall, this movie gets a 10 out of 10. It's an amazing brilliant masterpiece. So that's my review on Puss in Boots: The Last Wish. I hope you enjoyed the intro. So stay tuned. So I got a couple rants in the works. So you wanted it, you have to wait and see until next week or maybe week after. Depends on my work schedule. And my next review is my Puss fanboy's favorite Disney film of all time, Wish. That's my next review coming next week. Well, hopefully next week, because who knows, I might be at work at the time when this comes to Disney Plus. So am I excited to watch Wish? I'm kind of skeptical, but at the same time, because it has received mixed reviews, and there's a lot of people didn't really like the movie. I know Michael Spangler, he loved the film, but like I said, guys, it's not gonna be a rant. Don't worry, guys, it won't be a rant. The Wild is far worse. Far worse. That'll always be the worst Disney film of all time, along with Chicken Little and Home of the Range. So, anyway, I usually say thank you guys for watching, subscribe to the channel, like and share to your friends. Until next time, goodbye, like I used to. But honestly, I got one certain character is going to wish to say thank you guys for watching this video, and that is the wolf, Death Norris, the wolf himself. Take it away. Well, you guys made it to the end of the video. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the Lambo Rock Strikes Back review on Puss in Boots: The Last Wish. I hope he enjoys his £9,000 money. I wonder who's gonna do it on. Maybe he can save it to get his own place. Even though buying a place in the UK is very expensive. You probably know what I mean. So, anyway, that's it. I'll wrap it up now. Let's see, how was to say it? the way I usually say it. Okay. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Like and share with your friends. You might see me as a potential off-topic stop as my characterizations, since he's working on his next characterization of Mr. Burns for The Simpsons. He's gonna do him next, along with Smithers. His you probably know me. So anyway, see you guys. Goodbye. Chirp.